Okay, today I'm going to address one of the few things that I dislike about my Brothers SQ9185, which I actually like this machine a lot. I've had it for a few months now, done a lot of, hemming up things, sewing jeans, made a few little bags. But today I'm going to address a question that I've been asked a few times, and it's a very important question. The machine embroiders, but the font size, it's set at a real small font size, and I'm demonstrate that in a second. Then I'm demonstrate how you can make the font size any size you want. So right now I just have the in foot in, and I'm going to just do a quick little word, the word test. So I'm using this yellow fabric and just some little canvas, duck canvas, and I have a blue contrasting thread, so you'll be able to see it. So let me set that up in a second. Again, well, I already have the end foot in, but I'm going to spell out the word test, and then we'll see.
So first thing you want to do is put your indicator and push the button until the green light is over the A for font. Come up here and I'm going to do the word test. So if your screen already has any numbers right here, you want to hit the delete. This is the delete. Sorry about the darkness. This is the delete. And as you can see, it's one, now zero. So now I can spell any word I want. So test is, the T is 20. So it's just simply, that's T, add. Now the E is 05, add. The S is 19, add. And then the T is 20, add. So that's how you, that's just how easy it is to type a letter in. So now, again, I have presser foot in, and let me show you what that looks like. I'm about to go ahead and spell the word in. I put it on high speed, low, medium, high. I dropped the arm, but you don't even have to push the button down, and I just hit go. I'm gonna zoom you in so you can see what it looks like. So anytime I'm letting the machine, anytime I'm doing any type of monogramming, I just let the machine do it by itself. When I go and change feet and I do it freehand, I like to use the foot control. You just have that much better control. Okay, so it slowed down, it stopped. Take a look, needle up. Go ahead and cut it. And here is the word.
You see, it just spelled the word test. It's exactly what we wanted to spell. But let's just say this wasn't the size you want. Even though it looks nice, you know, obviously you would just go up in here and snip off the little thread that you don't want. Even though it looks nice, if you just wanted something bigger, this just wouldn't work. So I'm about to show you how you can get the size that you want. Hold on a second.
Right here, I have the same fabric next to test that we just did. I just have a pin. Obviously, if you get a sewing pin, it's a little better because the ink is washable, but this is just an example. Now also remember, this is a sewing test, not a judge my handwriting. All right, so I'm just going to draw right on here. The word test, I just wrote test a lot bigger than what the sewing machine was able to sew out. Now, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna change feet, and we're gonna change the feet. We're gonna put this spring action quilting foot on. Let me see if I can get that into focus for you. The spring action quilting foot. So let me show you how you hook that up.
What you want to do, you want to take your little screwdriver and loosen up this screw. loosen that screw up. The whole unit and the foot, the whole presser foot and the foot comes out. And then you want to put your spring action quilted foot in. Now, with this foot, all you do is the part that you unscrew, that screw, this slides up under that screw, and this little arm right here, I'm in trouble, this little arm sits on top of the this little arm over here. You'll see what I'm talking about in a second. So you simply slide this back under. I can do this. Slide this back under. Tighten the screw. Now your presser foot is on. Now, let me show you what I'm talking about.
I don't know if you can see this, but the little arm that I showed you from the quilting foot is just resting on top of this. So as this, the needle arm, as it goes up, it lifts this up because it's pushing on top of that little arm. I don't know if you can see, okay. It's pushing on that little arm. And so as it goes up, you can move your fabric, and then as it comes down, it holds it. So I'm go ahead, load our fabric, and stitch out the word.
Now, before we start sewing our word test, you have to remember, you have to take your hand and go up under here and hit that little lever to lower your feed dog feet. Then you put the thread through the quilting, spring action quilting foot. Then you have to remember to lower your presser foot. Even though the quilting foot won't touch the fabric, you have to lower that. So you simply line it up, and I'm going to just use a straight stitch, which is 0-0, whatever length you want. I'm gonna go for a shorter length. I have a length of 2. Again, since I'm doing freehand, I like to use the foot control, and I have the foot control on high because you can control it. So I'm simply going to follow the guideline. And obviously you want to keep your hands out of the way. And then the better you get, the faster you can go. And then needle up. Raise my presser foot. The good thing about this hands-free quilter, it has an indicator so you know exactly where to start the needle again. And you can see through it, so you can see exactly, well not exactly, but you can see through it. Raise up your presser foot. Let me clean this up a little bit. Okay, as you can see, I've cleaned up the little straggly thread. Here's the Brothers embroidered test, and here's my test. A lot bigger. Obviously, you can make it as big as you want because it's freehand. Not as neat, but that's on me, not the sewing machine.
Okay, I was trying to zoom in so you could see these little red marks. I don't know how clear it's coming up on the camera, so I'll take it off again so you can see it. But since it's plastic, you can see through and follow the line that you drew on the fabric. And like I said, these little red indicators let you know where to line up your needle. I'll take that off and you can see, get a better view of that. Those are the little red indicators I was talking about. And you see how you can see through it somewhat. And that's how you can follow the lines. How this works, as the sewing machine goes up and down the needle is making this go up and down, so it holds the fabric every down, so it doesn't lift the fabric up all over the place. But that is how you can use the Brothers SQ9185 to do your own freehand embroidery, to do it at any size you want. Obviously, you can do characters, you can do bigger words, you can do shapes, you can do anything you want freehand. That's on you. It's not the machine. Don't blame the machine. If it doesn't come out looking good, that's on you. Okay, as usual, I appreciate you watching, and you guys have a nice day. Oh, one quick thing before I leave. Since I've had this machine, there's been a few things I've made. One is this little cell phone holder. It's for, if my wife, she goes to the beach or something, she can just put her cell phone in here and use one of her purse straps to just hook it up so it just holds her phone and maybe her ID. Then I made this little bag here, little drawstring bag, just to hold all my crafting items. So that just pulls on both sides. Okay, I'm using my assistant here to show you just how it closes, okay? So you just pull either side, just pull both sides, and it just closes up. You know, just your typical little drawstring bag. But those are the two big things that I've made. Did some hemming, fixed some of our clothes, and pretty much that's it. So, like I said earlier, this video was about embroidering, as usual. I appreciate you guys watching again. Have a nice day. If you have any questions, feel free to hit me up and I will answer them as soon as possible. As a bonus, I did the word test two more times at two different font sizes. Right here, that's the Brother Sewing Machine font size. I did another name, and I also did a heart at the top. So you can see with a little bit of practice, you will be able to make the size that you want.